In the photograph displayed lives a historic archive where the lady on the left, together with her mother, explored the newfound freedom where apartheid came to an abrupt end and the citizens were no longer segregated. Kippies, not just a structure, forms part of this history where this particular photograph was taken. This is how the narrative journeys.
My name is Margaret Fuljoen. I am 49 years old and born and bred in El Dorado Park. Okay, on this particular day, it was a Saturday, and we decided to go to the flea market that was at the market theater. You know, the whole place was surrounded by like a whole lot of stalls and stuff like that. And we had a pleasant day. There's my mother, my brother, and there's a particular young man. A particular young man that we took out for lunch, you know. And yeah, we were just showing him around and everything. And we did our walkabout at the flea market, bought a few things, and then we stumbled upon Kippies. And then we looked at the place and we just decided that, you know what, this would make a nice picture. So we lined up ourselves, and this picture was taken by my brother Victor. The fondest memories of that day was that we went. Our plan was to go to the flea market and just have a day of fun. Just, you know, an outing, and meet people, different people. And that was in 1995, and yeah, it was a beautiful day. We were just out in the sun, you know, mingling and mixing with different people, meeting different people. It was exciting. It's really, you know, it's really memorable. And yeah, we used to do that often. Well, the transition from apartheid, it was like, for us, it was exciting times because we could go to places that we could never go to. We could meet up with people that we never could. So it was exciting times because, you know, coming from, you know, apartheid times and everything, where we were restricted to so many places, we could, there's lots of things that we couldn't do. And now here we are. We are, you know, it's like the missing piece of the puzzle, you know, was found, and everything came together in terms of us meeting with different race groups, and, you know, us being able to go to places that we were not allowed at. Wow, it was amazing. You'd have different, you know, it's like people came out, people were, it's like, you know, people were free, you know, and it was expressed through their clothing and the way they dressed. And it was like anything goes. You can slap, you know, just something and throw it around yourself, and you take your sandals and there you go. Like, as you can see in this picture, this is my own creation. I was like very fashion forward, and I just took a sarong and I wrapped it around myself. I took my t-shirt, you know, I did a couple of tucks, and, you know, and I had my Africa necklace on, and, you know, my sandal. And I actually conscientized my mother to just also put on her sarong and everything, and then there we go, because we're heading to the flea market, you know, where you find your different types of styles and your different types of people, and you find your hippies, you find your, you know, your punks, Oh yes, the punks were big, and they were big in that day. And it's like, yeah, I was somewhat of a trendsetter, I could say. I used to just do my own thing, just to stand out and to be different. And I just loved that. At Kippies, a lot of artists used to play there. Like, you know, and especially your jazz musicians and stuff like Sipo Hot Sticks Mamuse. I wanna burn out all my love. That type of music, Rayuma Sekela, the likes of your Marima Kevas, and you know, even in later years, your younger musicians used to infiltrate the place as well, like your Bongo Muffins and you know, those people and stuff like that. It was an exciting place to be at, and it was like, it was very chilled, and it was you know, it was like a nice social, you know, a spot to hang out and, you know, meet people, have a couple of drinks, and you know, network also, and it was amazing.
This is the true meaning of Reminisce.